cambiaria.
Can you bring me this for the cooking? You can put it on the pork, chicken.
It's like a spinach. I think it looks more like a fenugreek leaf, but in New Mexico it will have a different name for it. She said you could use it to mix it in your meat, your chicken, your beef.
It's
like a spinach. Yeah. What's the name of it in Mexico here?
Verdolaga.
Verdolaga. So food is when you shop around, you know, in NYC. We do see this a lot in the Asian supermarket and in the Mexican one. So now I know what it is and I'm going to give it a try.
It's delicious.
There you go. So foodies, this is tomatillo. It's like a green tomato. It has a sticky texture. And as you see in some of my breakfast I was enjoying at the resort, they had that verde. It's a sauce, meaning a green sauce. And I also want to show to you the ones that it has a little cover over, like a little, let me just move over. Here we go. So there you go. This is what it looked like. This is the cover. You see the nice little cover. And I show you the one without, and this is the one with. So they usually will take it out if you want to have it like that. Give it a nice little boil, steam it down, zap it, and make a beautiful green sauce. And this foodie is this spiky dude over here. We all know, Christophine, known in the island of Trinidad and Tobago. My Jamaican brothers and sisters, they know this as Chocho. And Chayote, Spanish. And over here too in Mexico, we see Chayote. Espinosa. So there's the prickly ones, but the ones in Trinidad and in the Caribbean islands, Jamaica, Barbados, it's smooth. It doesn't have that spike in it. And here, these are some squash, some pumpkin squash. I'm gonna go around. And you all know that poblano pepper. This is the number one chili poblano, as you can see. As I always tell you, the Mexican pepper that has the closest taste to that pimento peppers. Yeah. Oh, this is a here. This is a Trini one, the chochod or the Christophine. Make this in a lot of our chow mein. There you go, and vegetables. And the tomatale. So this vendor here, I absolutely love her. I wish she was in New York. This is the nopal or tuna or ratchet. She cleaned it up already for you, and this is what I really like. So as you can see, she cut the spikes out already, so this is all ready. You clean it up nice and give it a nice cut there in the strips. And of course, you know the chili jalapeno. We all know all these here. This is the chili serrano. We know this from back all the time with you. And we all know this. This is very blanched taste. This is very nice. I never did introduce you to this. There you go. Jumaya. When I go back to New York, I'm going to purchase one and I will cut it open in the kitchen and show to you what it is like. It's a blanched, crispy, watery taste it has there. No taste in particular, it's just like bland. And you can also do some recipes with it, which I promise I will do to show to you. Foodies, look at this, all my islanders and all my foodies in the Caribbean islands and in those countries that sell that grow sugar cane. There we go, we got the sugar cane. And in Trinidad, we have one in Milk Bob. How many of you remember Milk Bob and the red skin cane? So there you go, sugar cane. And I think I'm going to grab a glass of this juice in a little bit. And pineapple, you know, beautiful pineapple everywhere you go. And this is our pumpkin. What is this? Hola. Hi. What is this?
Pino de Navidad.
Cebolla. Cebolla, which is a fruit. You could just eat this fruit as it is. I do not know what it looked like. This is one here that went bad, so we could just dip into it. Also, it is like a plum. It's like a whole plum, if you all know. But this one went bad, so that's why I opened that one up to show to you. And one, you usually would make a punch with this one. You make a juice. I remember the juice that they made with this one. And this foodie is de cocote. And I remember seeing this in NYC. And I think you can make juice and punches. And you can make like jam and stuff. It's a fruit. So, you know, you treat it as a fruit. It's a Mexican fruit. So let's move along. And of course, the mangoes. You know, we love the mangoes. And you know, when you see those spots in the mango, you know, it's very sweet. Lots of Mexican
Smells really great.
Nice and spicy. Spiced mangoes. And here we have
silfig.
And if you don't know, lovely silfig here, banana. And you know the guayabas or guava. Yep, delicious. This one is a tiki fish. You see how tiny this one is? This is like a silfig, very sweet. And we used to eat this fig, I remember we used to eat it with roti. Roti in the morning and like lunchtime food and finish cooking. See, Granny used to open up one of this here, put it in a quarter roti and eat that. And this one is a tiki fig, meaning chiquito fig, the smaller ones. When it's half ripe, Granny will boil this. And I have a recipe on the page where you will boil it, just a gentle boil, fried up with some onion, pepper, and garlic, and whatever have you, and you enjoy that just as it is. And here, my dear foodies, you know, the rough skin lemon. This is a smaller one, but this is the rough skin lemon. You see, it's actually very rough on the skin. And this, you know, we use this to wash the meats and whatever. Even when we used to wash clothes and we had the rainwater, Granny used to squeeze this, so it's to cut that sliminess and soapiness out from the water. And it's great to take a shower to remember. She used to scrub us down with it. Lots more guava, apple, melon. Remember putigal? So this is, or they say mandarin or tangerine over here, but I will say putigal. So foodies, I learned something here in Mexico that the peppers, and I actually put them out to show to you. This is molita. This is a dry one and it's medium spicy. This is the banana pepper when it's dry, chile pasilla. So when it's green, it's a different name. Now this here, poblano, when it's green, and when it's dry, it's a different name. So this is it here. And you all know this is a sweet pepper, as I told you, like a pimento pepper. So when it's dry to perfection, it's a different name. And you know how to use it. You give it a good wash and you pour it into boiling water and it will just hydrate itself back up. Another one here is the chili de arbol. This is the red. I found a green one here just to show to you. But it's the red one and it's dry to perfection, just like the Indian chilies that you use. This has a heat from 1 to 10, 10 being the most. This is like an 8. There you go. And this one, this is another jalapeno, but it's a small jalapeno and small. And when it's dried, it's another name for it. So this is it here. And this one is a regular big jalapeno that is green. And when it's dried, they have different sizes, you will get it. So it gets heat, you know, once it's dry and dehydrated, if whatever heat there is, it will just be a little more. So the dry one is always a little more spicy. Interesting there. So here we have tamarind. We all know tamarind. Tamarino, tamarind. I mean, tamarind bowl, tamarind sauce, tamarind chutney, and all of that. And this is called hibiscus. But do you know what this is? This is just our simple little sorrel, also known as I have the African name for it. I forgot the African name for it. It'll come to me just now. Zobo. That's correct. Zobo in Africa, hibiscus for the Latin. Because my husband's Puerto Rican, they call it that too, hibiscus. And for us in the island, we all know it as sorrel. Make that lovely sorrel drink, sorrel cake, sorrel punch, you name it, sorrel jam. So many things you can make. Oh, hi, my dear. What do you have here?
This is caloro. Is this Heineken?
So show me in the dry ones, which is this. So we have two peppers here. Is it pica or no pica? Mine?
No.
No pica, no pica. So it's not spicy. So which one is that over here? Okay, this one. So one of them, senora, I'll take it. So this is the banana pepper. So this is a very spicy one. So it could be like a long one. Like the banana one, so when it's dry it's one name and when it's green it's a different and fresh. And this is another short one. I saw it over here. One of these pepper, yeah, I think it's one of these over here. So, and this do have a little spice into it. And as we move on here, is this a pepper? Is a pepper? Chipotle. Oh, this is a chipotle. So foodies, you know that chipotle, that spicy little guy in the can and whatever. So we have the chipotle there. And of course we know this little round one. Panzano. This is spicy. You will find these also in the jars.
preserve. I have some that I did do some recipes for you. And it's the dry ones here. The hydrators, as I say, you use it. Or you keep it in the jar that you could just, you know, put it into any food. But it's spicy, mind you. And foodies, as we all know, that the habanero, we have the habanero peppers over here too. So foodies, this here is marjoram. Marjoram, it has a nice smell, something like the fine thyme, but the leaf is a little more bigger than the fine thyme. And here is the dry one. Sometimes it could be mistaken for oregano. It has that, wow, I could smell this all day. So you know when you use the green, when you use a dry one, you use less because it's more concentrated, and this is the green one. So you could blend this and make in your green seasoning. And when you see I do my spices and I said I'm on my herbs and I'm using dry herbs, you can use the dry one. But always remember to use less. And we did that garlic, then that garlic festival. Let me know how many of you know. Let me know how many of you remember which one of the garlic is this. This is the one with the purple. Leave me a comment below. Jenny's walking Mexico, taking you to see all your different fruits, vegetables, and you know I love the markets. Senora, this is a store. What is this?
It's a salad.
A salad? What is it? A salad. Is it a spinach?
La usan como para ensalada también, ¿verdad? Ensalada o licuado.
So you could use this in salads, or you could use it liquido. So you could make like a verde sauce de verde. So you could make a green sauce with it, because I see the wrong and I do not know what it is.
Este es igual. Este se llama pasote y lo utilizan como para...
Ah, pasote.
O sea, tú pones frijoles negros y este es para eso. Igual carne de cerdo, no, es negro.
Negro. Uh-huh. So this is pasote, like the pasote sopa de pasote.
Le sirve para la comida, para los frijoles, incluso para el té para su estómago, para los parásitos en ayuna,
yes.
También.
So she's saying this is a spinach and they to make a pasote, and I do have a pasote. The name of this is pasote. So you could use this, chop it together, and you can add it to your beans, like how you use spinach. It's very good for your stomach and your digestive system. You could add it into anything, as a matter of fact. It's like a spinach that flavors up food, beans, meats, and salads. So thank you very much. I'm seeing, ¿qué es esto?
Es frijol peruano higuera.
Harbueno higuera. It's a bean, it's a Mexican bean.
And cocinando es stew. No, tarda como una hora, hora 20 minutos cocinando. Es de los más blanditos que hay.
20 minutes time and you could make this
con arroz. Con agua,
just water and salt and boil it, but you can have it like with you make some rice and you can have this bean over it with like pollo, but is it solamente? So this foodies is Mexican bay leaf. You see how small this is? So I'm gonna grab a pack of this Mexican bay leaf. Look what I found, piloncillo, which is really sugar. Some of you all may know it as I have the white one and the black one. You also know this as jaggery. It's really cane sugar, so the Dominican, the Spanish, the Puerto Rican, they all use this. You will find them to make like their chocolate teas and stuff. You will use it, and in Indian cooking, they call it jaggery, pure cane sugar. Use it in lots of desserts and cooking, so there you go. And it's already, it has this unique shape, like a little dome, you see, that they will make it. Sometimes you will find it round, flat and round in the U.S. And in the Indian stores, you will find them in bottles. Jaggery, piloncillo, black one. They and the Indian has more like the reddish, pinkish looking color. Pure cane sugar. Here, Jenny's walking Mexico City. Look what I found. Soy texture. So you know that soy protein that is made from the soybean. Take a look at this. This is blanco, very much white. What I will get in the US is more the very dark ones. And the yellow looking ones, so this is, I like this. So you could use this as ground meat to make your vegetarian dishes like your lasagna, your meatballs and stuff. So I'm gonna take some of this. Of course, if you cannot get this one, I'm just gonna try it because you know it's from here in Mexico. I'm just taking a mention, you know, we could reflect back in our shopping here in Mexico. So we're gonna make a lovely dish with our soy protein here from Mexico.